Welcome to our CW39 Digital Dive, and who do we have with us today?
Well, my name is Frank Rutherford, 1992 Olympic bronze medalist, actually the first Bahamian to win an Olympic medal for the Bahamas. And, you know, it's a pleasure to be here with you today, and I can't be so thankful for you guys to be hosting me here today.
We don't usually get golden bronze medals, any kind of Olympic medals here. You have a big event coming up to talk about with us, don't you?
Yeah, I'm here to talk to you guys today and to encourage our public to come and support the Darling Dash that's happening this Sunday on the 25th of February. And it's in honor of my deceased nephew who passed away as a result of having a sickle cell trait.
Yeah, and you talked about you played for Florida State in 2000. He unfortunately collapsed and passed away at that. And you know, I remember hearing the story, and it just talks about how, you know, sickle cells is still a very something that a lot of African American men need to think about, especially young African American men. Just tell me how important it is for young African American men to know about getting tested and knowing if they have that sickle cell trait in them.
It's absolutely, I think, eminently important for parents, coaches, and the athlete themselves, not just African Americans, all football players, regardless of your ethnicity, because sickle cell and sickle cell trait is something that goes in our bloodstream or part of our blood makeup that we don't have an understanding of unless we're tested for it. And basically what it is when your red blood cell is not completely formed, and it's what they call, like in a moon shape, it's called sickled. That's where the terminology sickle cell come from. That doesn't allow the blood to receive oxygen to be able to spread through revitalizing your blood, to revitalize your organs and everything else. And when you don't get proper oxygen, it suffocates you and shuts you down, and could lead to you dying, which happened to my nephew in 2001 on the 26th of February at Florida State as a young 18-year-old football player. Devaughn Darling was perhaps one of the first young men to be unfortunately taken away from us off this earth as a result of us not knowing he had having a sickle cell trait.
And now I remember hearing about that, you know, 24 years ago. That was a very tragic incident. Is that the motivation for starting this foundation too as well?
This is absolutely the only reason why we started the foundation. Because we wanted, first of all, to talk about my nephew Devaughn. He was a twin. He was an identical twin. Mm-hmm. His twin brother, who is the impetus of carrying on his legacy and their legacy, I bought them from the Bahamas when they were 9 years old here in the state of Texas, and raised them here and introduced them to the game of football, which I came here back in 1982 on a track scholarship at the University of Houston from the Bahamas. And consequently, you know, teammates like Carl Lewis, my best friend Akeem Olajuwon, all of us, Clyde Drexler, all of us on the same campus that helped me to win our country, the Bahamas' first Olympic medals, first world championship medals, which inspired our nation and many young people like my nephews to want to use sports to get an education. So I brought them along with their older brother, Dennis Darling, and they got involved in playing the game of football, and they wanted to use that sport for the purpose of getting education, but at the same time to financially put themselves in position to take their mom, my aunt, you know, to a place where she would not have to worry about her financial future. Unfortunately, Devaughn passed away on the, like I said, as a result of the sickle cell trait. Yeah. Devaughn, his twin, identical twin brother, went on to Florida, to Washington State, where he became the first Bahamian to be drafted in the third round. And then he was able to carry on the message, and he started the AS1 Foundation to educate the public on how this disease can take away a young person, a young athlete. And so consequently, from 2001, this foundation has been educating the whole world, the U.S., everybody about this disease, yeah. Sickle cell.
I mean, and that's just an amazing story to come from Bahamas to bring to learn these twins to learn to sport football. They had great success in high school, and to go to top tier D1 colleges, unfortunately, for one to pass away because of this sickle cell trait, but for one to have success and to say, hey, I'm going to educate everyone about the trait that took away my brother. It's just a tremendous story, and I'm glad to see that it's that you are educating everybody about this, and to educate, you know, young ones to, hey, we need to get tested about it so this does not happen again. Definitely something to remember. And where can get everyone can get more information about this for the event on Sunday?
Well, they can go to the AS1Foundation.com and register, and we need the participation of everybody because all the funds that's generated from the Darling Dash and all of the events that the AS1 Foundation do. It's strictly to educate and to help fund any type of organization that helps to educate and save lives of not just young athletes, but anybody that have sickle cell trait.
Yes.
And also to make sure people understand the value of hydration. You know, because the antidote to the sickle cell trait, an athlete who's training, or anybody who just have it regularly, you have to keep yourself saturated with water. That one element is what took Devaughn Darling away. The fact that they did not give him water, that's what happened. At Florida State, during his workout, for some reason or other, that old school football training where you don't allow your athletes to drink water back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, and 90s, early 2000s, well, Florida State had that type of mentality back then.
Yeah.
And consequently, as a result of not giving my nephew water, sicklings took over his body, shut him down, and he's no longer here.
Yeah.
So his legacy has been carried on today by the AS1 Foundation to educate so that we understand the seriousness of hydration, the seriousness of what the sickle cell thing is all about.
And that's a very important thing, and I think a lot of pro football teams, football programs have stressed that now. They've made a lot of changes to give players water. There's a lot more water breaks. There's a lot more in practices, water breaks in practices, water breaks in games. To coaches are stressing players to drink more water, hydrate themselves, keep themselves hydrated. So there have been changes, unfortunately, since that accident happened.
It's very important you bring that point up because I'm still involved so much in college athletics.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still involved so much in the development of young football and basketball players who are trying to get a D1 scholarship for education. I often remind people that the fact that you see those Gatorade orange hydration stations everywhere you go in high school athletics, everywhere you go in college athletics and the pros, actually stemmed from the fact that Devaughn Darling was the first one. And also, the NCAA has instituted the defibrillators.
That's right.
Been put in every, and being kept in every place where you see student athletes are training.
Mm-hmm.
All that as a result of my nephew passing away.
Absolutely.
And so they've stepped up to make sure, put these preventative measures in place.
Absolutely.
As a result of Devaughn Darling.
Absolutely. There have been changes made at the high school level and at the college level to put these emergency measures in for situations like what happens with your nephew.
Yeah, because one life loss is too much.
Absolutely.
Especially at the age of 16, 15, 18, or even 99.
Absolutely.
If you have the education to be able to not make those events happen, and that's what the AS1 Foundation is all about.
Absolutely.
Is to educate, and so we want everybody to show up for that AS1 Foundation fun run. It's this Sunday, starting at 7 a.m. Just go to the AS1 Foundation website, and all the information is there to register.
That's right. So everybody be there on Sunday to join them in the fun run and help fight the sickle cell and definitely have some fun. So thank you for joining us and telling us about the story. And thank you for joining us on our CW39 Digital Dive.
Thank you for having me.